In previous video, I explained you about resistance in series connection. In this video, we can see about parallel connection. So, what is parallel? See here, you consider three resistance. You are connected three resistance in parallel. Okay. So, what is a parallel? See, the both end of the resistance is connected to another resistance. Okay. So, this is in parallel connection. In parallel connection, the current through this resistance will be different. Okay. Then similarly voltage across each resistance will be same. In previous case, in series connection, current will be same through all resistance, but in parallel connection current will be different across each branch. In that voltage will be different across each resistance, but in parallel connection voltage will be same. Okay. Now we can apply Ohm's law. So here current I1, I2, I3 you have to find. Okay. Then I is equal to V by R. So you have to take for I1, I2, I3. Then I1 is equal to V by R1. Similarly, V by R2 and V by R3. Here you shouldn't take V1, 2, 3. Because voltage will be same through all the resistance. Okay. Now sum of total current. Total current is equal to the sum of branch current. So I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. Now you substitute this I1, I2, I3 in this place. So what is the thing? I is equal to V by, you are getting the 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So this is in the denominator form. Okay. Then 1 by R, so we can have to write it as 1 by R effective resistance equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. If we consider, let us consider two resistance in series now. So I am taking R1 and R2 alone. So if this two is in two resistance in parallel, what is the thing? We have to take LCM, 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. So you take this LCM. So what is the answer you will get? If you take this LCM, you will be getting R1 R2 by R1 into R2. So this is in the form of fraction, 1 by R effective. Now if we want to get effective resistance, and what is the condition? R effective is equal to, you have to take reciprocal. So what is the thing? R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. Okay. Now when both the resistance are in parallel, you can what is the thing? So R1 and R2 is parallel. So now what is the thing?